This is a production of PBS 39.
For some, music is a source of entertainment and inspiration. But the folks at Music Therapy Associates say music has a direct impact on the brain and is capable of changing lives. Nicole Brewer shows us how.
This may look like your average sing-along, with catchy lyrics and easy-to-strum guitar strings.
Most of the clients that we're working with don't realize all the different goals that we're working on. They just feel that they're having fun with music.
But it's more than fun and games. For 10-year-old Kathleen DeZube, it's music therapy.
Music therapy is the use of music to achieve behavioral goals that aren't necessarily music-related goals.
Designed for individuals with special needs, Kathleen has received music therapy for 5 years, taking part in both individual and group sessions. Her mother believes it helps her achieve certain social and emotional goals that are sometimes difficult for children with Down syndrome.
I think it has done a lot of good for her. It has increased her self-confidence. I believe she's more outgoing, and I can see it helping in just a lot of general areas in her life.
And according to Kathy Purcell, that's what music therapy is all about.
Improving speech goals, motor coordination, following directions, paying attention, those kind of things that aren't necessarily musical, but we're using music to work on those specific goals.
Founded in 1990, Music Therapy Associates is a private therapy practice serving clients of all ages and abilities. The staff, which includes 4 board-certified music therapists and 1 recreational therapist, provide individual and group sessions, like this one at Kathleen's school.
All of our services are individualized to each specific client. And if we're working with a group, we still have specific things that are tailored to that group.
At Mercy Special Learning Center, services are offered to children ages 3 to 21. And while the activities differ based on individual abilities, every session begins with a song.
1, 2, 3. Hello, everyone. Hello, everyone.
We will always start with a hello song, and that is to let the client or group know that the session has begun.
So what happens during the typical hour-long music therapy session?
That includes playing instruments, singing, dancing to music. It can also include improvising to music, making up songs, creating things, creating movements.
In this session, the students were introduced to Irish step dancing and invited to take part. And while this student was able to perform an impromptu dance in front of the group, not everyone can, but teachers say that's okay.
Here at school, we have those who can communicate and those who can't communicate. Some very limited, some have very verbal skills. So we use music as a tool for everyone to express themselves.
And that means everybody gets a turn to tickle the ivories or strum the strings.
We do really want the kids to have an opportunity and adults to have an opportunity to have an individual turn to do something. And it is important for them to be able to see, to sing or speak in front of the group.
And it's these opportunities that Heather says are so important in achieving social confidence.
Just to have them maybe start to take, say, my guitar, put it into their own hands and play the guitar, you just see their eyes light up. And you just know that, you know, you've achieved self-esteem.
It makes you feel good. When you can participate with the child next to you on your right and your left and in the whole group situation, you feel good about it.
Special education teacher Vicki McHale says the sessions also promote cognitive development.
If you can listen to the beat of the music and you can clap along or follow along, learning becomes a little bit easier.
And while most of the students' participation revolves around songs and instruments, music therapy also uses visual aids, such as parachutes or ribbons, to enhance learning.
The purpose of the non-musical tools is to keep the student engaged in what they're doing and to provide them a visual aspect for what we're talking about or what we're working with.
And it seems to be working.
They're having fun. You can see that on their faces. And they don't even realize they're learning while they're having fun.
And that's why music therapy gets a stamp of approval from parents like Laura DeZube.
It just makes me feel good, too, just to see her having a lot of fun.
And in a world where individuals with special needs may encounter challenges, Music Therapy Associates work to give Kathleen and her friends an opportunity to learn and grow in a way that's fun. For Tempo, I'm Nicole Brewer reporting.